have no interest in third-party launchers yet. Maybe in the future. We'll have to see.
So, you were saying...
I'm sorry, I thought I made this clear. I have no interest in third-party launchers. I think they are pointless. I don't think it adds anything for most launchers. I know, like, a couple. I mean, is it really that...
You just use the default Minecraft launcher, right?
Yeah, of course. Why would I use something potentially worse, or something like T-Launcher, which is horrible, and those weird PvP...
No, I think...
I'm not finished. As I was saying, those days of not using a custom Minecraft launcher have come to a close. Prism Launcher!
Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah!
Good morning, afternoon, everyone. If you've watched my channel before, you know I use the default Minecraft launcher. It is a perfectly chromulate launcher. However, over the recent weeks, I have not been using the default Minecraft launcher and now using something else. That thing is Prism Launcher. Today, I'm gonna cover what is it, how I discovered it, why I switched, and why I stayed. Let's get right into it. But what is Prism Launcher? A Minecraft launcher named Prism. Okay, but seriously. Prism Launcher is a free and open source third-party Minecraft launcher. It uses the instance system, which basically means you can create a new .minecraft for a different instance of Minecraft. You can easily download mods, shaders, resource pack from ModRiv and CurseForge. You can also easily update mods. Prism Launcher also uses a Qt toolkit with support for theming. If you're on Linux, you could also use Quantum, but do be careful. It may break it. I am using KV Libet Vital right now, and it looks unbroken. How did I know it though? I hate to admit it, but I first heard of it through drama. A while ago, PolyMC founder Lenny.
I'm Lenny. This is Carlin Homer. I'm Lenny.
Went rogue and basically kicked everyone from the project to own the libs or whatever. If you want to know more about this topic, check out this video by Brodie Robertson. So, the developers all moved to Prism Launcher, and that's how I know it. I was basically not using any third-party launcher at the time, so I didn't care, but the launcher is now known to exist for me, and it's also open source, which is a big factor for me to consider using something third-party. If I did not switch then, why did I switch now? On the 7th of June 2023, the malware Fracturizer hit. The malware infects Linux and Windows PCs. Hey, we are now being targeted. Does that mean we are important? Probably not. One of the few safer things is Flatpack. See, Minecraft Java is really broken in its permission and has access to a lot of things they really should not have access to. Flatpack is a sandbox solution on Linux that increases security. As Oro with 2OS, I'm a big fan, said, if you use Linux, use the Prism Launcher Flatpack. And be very careful of what you give it access to through utilities such as Flatseal. By default, it has no access to the needed directories to compromise the system. Other sandbox escapes may be possible, but the malware most likely doesn't account for running inside of a sandbox of sort. So I decided, you know what? Going forward, I'm using the Flatpak version. There is a repackaged Minecraft launcher in FlatHub, but it signs you out every time, so it's annoying. I decide to switch to Prism Launcher instead. But if you made it this far into the video, consider liking and subscribing. I am also going to do a small Q&A section on my 7th anniversary on August 9th. You can leave questions on this video or the post on my community tab. Why did I stay though? To keep it simple, mod updates, Flatpak instances. I like how you can easily update your mods directly from ModRiv or CurseForge. I think it's a generally useful feature, a one-click update for mods, except those like replay mods. I also like that it officially supports Flatpak, a universal and more secure way of distributing applications on Linux, which has made malware like Fracturizers not work. I like the multiple instances of how you can have different .minecraft for each mod packs you play. This is doable in the default Minecraft launcher, but it takes more effort. This one is just automatic like that. This launcher makes everything about installing mods in Minecraft easier. You can install Forge and Fabric in one click. I remember getting into Minecraft modding and I was a little bit confused since I was coming from Bedrock with the add-on system. I think this goes a long way in making it even easier than Minecraft Bedrock add-on, I would argue. So, in conclusion, I think this is a very good Minecraft launcher, and the fact that it is free and open source means that they aren't gonna do anything sketchy with it, because you can go read the source code. They have a Discord server where you can ask questions and have people help you with whatever issue you might have. If you're into modding, or at least using an Optifine alternatives, because you know you have to find all of mods and you know pack them together, I very much recommend this, as it makes it a whole lot easier. That will be it for this video. Tell me what launchers you use in the comments down below. And have I convinced you to use Prism Launcher, or perhaps a launcher like it? Cue the outro!